kid from BYU. Joined the 1:44 second club in the 800 meters back in April in Tempe. Walker was third at this year's NCAAs. Latest time was here, Shaquille Walker in lane 4. Lee Murphy is in 6. On their way in this 800, top three finishers automatically move ahead and the next two fastest overall.
I like Murphy. He's a real detail-oriented guy, likes to study the sport, likes to have everything in order. His coach, Lee DeVay, said that Murphy does the travel itinerary for the Akron team, doesn't like anything to be out of place.
Brandon Johnson takes the early lead. Walker into second place. Murphy was a bit of a surprise to make the U.S. team last year and went to the World Championships in Beijing. Made it to the semifinal, did not make the final. There is Murphy, mid-pack at the moment. With Johnson leading, there's the bell. Johnson leads to Walker with Jock in third, Ingles is fourth, and Murphy still back in the back.
This pace a little more sensible than what Boris Berrien put out there. I should clarify that Murphy was fourth in the U.S. Championship. Nick Simmons chose not to go to Beijing, and that gave Murphy a chance to get on the team. And Murphy better look to find some space to run here.
There he goes as Charles Jock comes up to join the leaders. Brandon Johnson still leading it with Walker in second place. It's all Jock and Murphy.
It's all well and good to have good finishing strength, but as you saw with Kate Grace in the women's race, you've got to be in the right position, and it looks like Murphy is setting himself up well for the home stretch.
Brandon Johnson leads into the home straightaway. Walker is in second place. Here's Murphy on the outside. Top three automatically advance, and there's a runner that fell as Murphy and Johnson hit the line together.
Given the pedestrian nature of that time, looks like the two-time qualifiers, Harris and Abdi, will come out of the first of the two semifinals. Smart running by Brandon Johnson to get out front, and that keeps you out of the sort of trouble we saw in that home stretch. But Murphy had the big finish, and that's what you need in these championship 800-meter runs. We saw that so many years from Nick Simmons. Murphy on the outside. Look how relaxed he is. Johnson in front, working hard.
And there Craig Ingles would have hit Walker's heels and exactly. Fell.
Exactly. Ole Miss All-American Craig Ingles just got too close for comfort with Shaquille Walker. That affected Walker's race for sure, and you might see a petition from him to try to get into the final based on that. He might have to run 9 in the final.
So here are the official results in this semifinal heat. Remember, top three automatically move ahead. That would be Murphy, Johnson, and Jock. Walker finishes in fourth place and does not have the time to advance, but if he protests, you might see him put in the final. We'll have to wait for that ruling.